Oh, really? I'm just picking Nagito all over the place.
You're the only one!
Well, you're one of two people, but...
Nagito, yeah. You should know.
Huh? What are you talking about?
Don't play dumb. You appeared so suddenly that one time because you used that method, right?
I've been wondering when or where
exactly
it deposits.
There's a secret passage connecting the first floor of Strawberry House to the third floor of Grape House.
Nagito looks so
salty.
Isn't
that right?
Yeah.
Jeez. Once again, I let the reserve course show off. But you're right. There's a door on the floor of the Octagon, which is on the first floor of Strawberry House.
50% salt, 50% thirst for Hinata. Oh no, Nagito's
After
not
I
the killer
opened
tech
the door
now.
And went
Absolutely
down.
Not. As was stated, once you've cleared the final dead room once, you can pass freely between the two houses, and you never have to repeat the dead room. He had to do the dead room when you controlled him. After the murder. So no, we're just nailing Gundam's coffin shut right now.
Surprise, surprise! I ended up in the Monokuma Archive, which is on the third floor of Grape House.
Meaning, the third floor and the fourth floor are actually connected.
Plus, once you've cleared the final dead room once, you can pass through it as many times as you want.
If they used that secret passage, they could have gone between the two houses as much as they wanted.
So I guess props to Gundam for actually getting through all that. It would have made for a slightly different crime if he'd shot himself in the head during Russian roulette.
Infinity Unlimited Flame!
Hey, I have that power too.
However, what if the killer was unaware of the existence of the final dead room?
There's no way they didn't know.
That is merely an illusion you have fabricated from your own suspicion. If you value your life, you should stop with your scrutiny.
There's no way I can stop.
Nagito is transformed into humanity's ultimate form, a pillar of pure salt. Yep, he'd be a good Twitch caster.
What did you say? Don't make me angry! You wouldn't like me when I'm angry!
Alright, so what are we gonna use? I'm actually not sure.
Even if the turbid box doesn't exist, you could travel through multiple planes, provided you use a spacious wormhole. However, how frail, I say! Your decayed illusion. Shall I feed you to the progeny of vile deities?
God, there's so many fucking directions.
I already proved a secret passage exists. The secret passage was at the Octagon.
Know the limits of your own reasoning! You say the killer went to the Octagon? Don't bark, you cur! If you don't want to at least pray to the key which dwells in the light!
I totally missed what that actual phrase was that I hit. Tell me to try providing the evidence that the killer went to the Octagon, right? Whoops. Yeah, five bullets in the chamber. Nagito really nailed it.
Know the limits of your own reasoning!
The wire.
You say the killer went to the Octagon? Don't bark, you cur! If you don't want to drown in the maelstrom of blind confusion,
oh, wait, no,
at
shit,
least pray to the key which dwells in the light!
Glad that I actually missed.
Know the limits of your own
okay,
reasoning! You say the killer went to the Octagon? Don't bark, you cur! If you don't want to drown in the maelstrom of blood.
Allow me to cut through those words!
No wire anywhere else in any of this
the
stuff.
The wire
so.
Used to string up Nekomaru's body. The hammer that looked like the weapon. And the chain on the door in the tower.
I'm surprised they didn't just use the chain that was actually on Nekomaru himself, but.
Those are all the items that weren't in Funhouse. Where did the killer obtain them?
The only place I can think of is the Octagon. There were various weapons and tools there. I'm pretty sure I saw stuff like wires, hammers, and chains, too.
Though to be fair, when we actually were poking around, we never encountered any of those things, which makes me a little sad.
Since those items were used in the crime, there's no doubt that the killer went to the Octagon.
If that's the case, they obviously know about the secret passage too, right?
It seems this is the end.
Oh, I'm sorry, Gundam.
Normally, we'd end up listening to Hajime lecture us with a very long summary of the case.
Goddamn, Nagito.
But there's no reason to waste any more time on this opening act. So I'm going to end this right now.
Hey, what are you...
First of all, by messing with all the clocks in the building, Gundam tried to lure only Nekomaru.
Oh my god, Nagito!
The elevator was probably broken by that point. Thanks to that, Nekomaru wasn't able to go to Grape Tower, which was supposed to be the meetup point. So he tried going over to Strawberry Tower, just like we did when we found out the elevator was broken. Well, it's obvious he'd attempt that. At that time, we didn't know the two towers were the exact same place. Also, the button in Strawberry Hall wasn't broken, so he was easily able to enter Strawberry Tower. But surprise! Gundam was waiting for Nekomaru's arrival!
Hold on. If Nekomaru didn't go to Strawberry Tower, what would the killer have done then?
Their plan was a balancing act of uncertainties, but even if they failed, they probably wouldn't have minded.
I wonder if the hamsters played Russian roulette too.
They can just greet everyone the next morning as if nothing happened, and come up with a different plan.
And, without such a risky plan, they wouldn't have been able to lure him at all.
I'm going to continue summarizing the case, okay?
I will laugh my ass off if he actually summarizes this and I don't have to do it myself.
Through this, Gundam successfully lured Nekomaru to Strawberry Tower. There's no way he could fight head-on with the robotic Nekomaru. So by pressing the goodnight button, he rendered Nekomaru powerless without fighting him.
Hold on! You... What did you just say? That I didn't battle?
What's wrong with that?
What if they actually did have to fight for him to hit it?
Don't mess with me!
Oh boy.
Don't mess with me! I cannot ignore those words!
Why are you angry all of a sudden?
You fools do not understand! You don't understand at all! Ha! You make me laugh! After all this time, you still don't understand anything at all!
Implying that he would do a sneak attack.
I don't understand anything. What does that mean?
It appears I cannot finish just yet. Maybe I'm just a human destined for hell. However, I cannot finish just yet. I cannot finish!
Oh god, is this gonna drag us into the PTA?
What do you intend to do?
It's obvious! I'm going to destroy your illusory assumptions!
Are you saying you still have more? You still have room to argue?
Your words. You said I pressed Nekomaru's goodnight button. However, that button was on the back of Nekomaru's neck. To press it, I'd have to get behind him.
It's not easy to get the drop on Coach Nekomaru.
It's even more difficult if it's a one-on-one situation.
Just as I thought, truly frail. Succumbing so easily to this simple argument, it was just a mere
illusion.
Don't
tell me he actually had a hamster do it. Hey, Al Fox, how are you?
If you want to set me up as the killer, at least surpass your own human limitations.
I was wondering if the hamsters would come into play.
That's wrong, Gundam. You're the one who's wrong.
Such a wonderful line.
Okay, this is going to be the PTA,
however,
and we're going to have to say, like, four dark devas, or the four dark devas will be the fucking four thing at the end.
Listen well. I shall teach you two tips for making someone admit their defeat.
You gotta figure, if he kills someone or if he dies, the hamsters have to be involved some way. Either the hamsters have a clue if he's killed, or if he kills someone, they have to be involved.
First, you must crush them with your own overwhelming power. And as for the other, you must provide a reason that will persuade that human. You have not fulfilled either of those yet.
And then everyone goes ahead and just votes anyways, and he dies. Hey, Tadilala. Didn't have a whole lot of theories going into the trial, but we managed to figure most things out before it actually came down to it. Sad that it's Gundam, though. No, sad that it's Gundam. I guess you really don't want to admit it. And just as you requested, I'll provide an argument that'll leave you no choice but to be persuaded. Let's proceed to yell at each other while I dance. Yep, we're gonna yell at each other while dancing.
I won't let you! For the Tanaka Empire! Wither!
At least we'll get awesome sound bites during this.
Crushed as David prophesized! I won't let you! For the Tanaka... Wither! Crushed as David prophesized!
Shit.
Show me the cadaver! Show me the cadaver!
You've already seen
I
that.
Won't let you! For the Tanaka Empire! Wither! Crushed as David prophesized! I won't let you! For the Tanaka Empire!
Shit.
Wither! Crushed as David prophesized! It's Nekomaru's back! Do you really think I can get behind him so easily?
I'm so sorry, dude. I'm so sorry, dude.
Even if you didn't get behind Nekomaru, you should have been able to press the button on the back of his neck. As long as you had the power of the hamsters you keep with you!
Oh?
Are you seriously saying he used his hamsters to press the button on the back of Nekomaru's neck?
Of course that'd be impossible for a normal hamster, but it would have been possible for Gundam.
Now we must go into a new portion of the trial in which we prove which of the four hamsters it was.
In fact, we saw that with our very own eyes, right?
Press the button. Emissary of evil, in accordance with our ancient contract, the time has come to lend me your aid. Pierce through Supernova Silver Fox Sandy. Beep. Oh no, Steve, what did you do? What did you do, Steve? Steve. Oh, thank you, Steve. Thank you, Steve. Oh, I even mentioned Catherine when we first got to this place. I'm saving that. That's magnificent. Truly, this is the skyline lamentation art of the demon mouse. Soon the door of destiny shall open. Damn it,
now
why did I show my hamsters
it.
Off?
After Ibuki was killed in the music venue, one of Gundam's hamsters retrieved the piece of wallpaper from the baton lighting, right? Hey! With your friends and their exceptionally smart brains, it must have been possible...
She's Catherine with a K.
...to secretly get one of them behind Nekomaru and press the button on the back of his neck.
How about it, Gundam?
Come on, Megatron Jones, give it up.
Not just myself, but you actually brought up how splendid my subordinates are. I have no recourse but to admit it.
Compliment his hamsters, cops to the crime.
Admit it? Did you say you admit it?
It appears I've obtained a one-way ticket to hell. Fine! Then you must trample me underfoot and advance. Victory can only be built upon a foundation of corpses. You cannot find peace without sacrifice anywhere.
Nah, I don't think I'll take that one, Pikachu.
Now, trample this life! Trample it as though it were mere trash on the side of the road! Pull the curtain strings of this worthless performance with your own two hands!
Aw, I wanted to go with Nagito's. Alright, what do we got? Vehiko can't sleep, huge hammer, alarm set for 5:30, 5 a.m. right now. Hamster pressed it. Alarm set for 5:30 a.m., it's 2:40 right now. forget which that one is. No, we're gonna assume the strawberry one first. Well, actually, this is probably happening... How early is this happening? Okay, not happening super early, so let's go with this one. Wait. Not which I thought it was. Okay, so it is the other one. It's the first mistake I've made in ages. Sleepy for Yahiko. Okay, sees him leave. I like the way he's walking in. Hamster attack. Alright, so it's not wire, it's not not the destruction. When does the hammer come into play? Ah, the fake weapon. I woke up. I'm gonna loop on the doorknob. Well, that's gonna happen in here, because it's already... What else we got? Alarm clock, knob came off. Breaking all the shit. Alarm clock's going off, he's trying to fix it. He wakes up around that time, freaks out, doorknob breaks. So sorry, dude. Well, not really. And that's probably me waking up.
Here's everything that happened in this case.
It's really short again.
Let's first go over the many tricks the killer prepared before they committed
the crime. Hamster's also
blackened
through. If they share his fate, I will laugh. Except accomplices aren't considered blackened. So it's his plan. So at most, the hamster's an accomplice and nothing will happen to it. Everyone looks so gaunt. Well, everyone's starving.
First, they destroyed the contact elevator. This separated Nagito and the others in Strawberry House from our group in Grape House. Next, they lured Nekomaru out by himself by turning back all the clocks in the funhouse by 2 hours. Additionally, in order to secure an alibi, the killer went to the Strawberry House lounge and set the wall clock's alarm to 5:30 a.m. After finishing their preparations, the killer went to Strawberry Tower with the necessary tools in hand. They obtained these tools from the Octagon, which you can enter once you clear the final dead room.
Call of Snow execution is often related to the ultimate. Not actually necessarily. Where was it? There weren't two people who had executions that didn't really feel like they were related at all. Like, honestly, the smashing in Danganronpa 1 isn't related to either person.
This means the killer discovered the secret of the funhouse faster than anybody else. That secret being, Strawberry House and Grape House are actually the same building. On the morning of the incident, Nekomaru woke up and headed over to Grape Tower for a specific reason.
Disappointed no accomplices have survived yet. Well, we've only had one accomplice.
There, Fuyuhiko, who was at the lounge by coincidence, witnessed Nekomaru. According to Fuyuhiko's testimony, that was around 5 a.m., but by that point, the killer had already messed with our perception of time. In actuality, Fuyuhiko witnessed Nekomaru at 7 a.m. That's also the same time Monokuma Tai Chi begins. Nekomaru went to Grape Tower to participate in that. However, because the contact elevator was broken, Nekomaru was unable to go to Grape Tower. So he decided to try going to Strawberry Tower.
Four Dark Devas.
But the killer was waiting for him there. With the power of hamsters, they were able to press the good night button on the back of Nekomaru's neck.
With the power of hamsters, ladies and gentlemen.
This forced him to enter sleep mode, rendering him immobile. From there, the killer began preparing to use the ultimate weapon. First, they set the alarm in Nekomaru's chest to 7:30 a.m. so he'd wake up. Then they tied him up with a metal wire, tied the tip of the wire into a loop, and hung it on the doorknob.
Imagine Imagine if it hadn't stayed on the doorknob and it just dropped off when the elevator started going down. He had to come in and keep doing this.
After leaving Strawberry Tower, the killer then destroyed the door button to Strawberry Hall. They did this to keep us from entering Strawberry Tower, and to keep us from discovering the secret of the building structure that they used to kill Negomaru. Then, they used the secret octagon passageway to travel to Grape House. After arriving at Grape Hall, they pressed the button to open the door to the tower.
Hey, Cubby!
When that happened, the elevator-like floor of the tower began descending, and Nekomaru's body was still inside, dangling upside down in midair from the wire. The killer entered Grape Tower to see if their setup was successful. And placed a hammer on the floor to look like the weapon, then wrapped a chain around the back door.
You don't trust more to pilot the Avenger, Bradford and Nagato? Why would I trust Nagato to pilot shit?
This was done to make us falsely believe we couldn't enter the tower from Strawberry Hall.
I like Nagato, doesn't mean I'm gonna trust him to do anything.
With this, the killer finished their setup and tried to go back to their room using the secret passage, so they could craft their alibi when Nekomaru died from the fall. But something unexpected happened. Fuyuhiko, who saw Nekomaru earlier, was still at the lounge. As a result, the killer couldn't return to their room, and with no options available, time ran out.
Oh, nice, Cubby. How'd it turn out? It all work well?
The lounge's wall clock alarm started ringing at 5:30. Well, actually 7:30. To avoid a worst-case scenario, the killer was forced to appear in front of Fuyuhiko with the others. When the wall clock's alarm rang, that was also the same time Nekomaru was waking up.
Imagine if he just hadn't struggled, we'd all shown up for Tai Chi and been like, hey dude, who hung you up there? Hamster boy.
He woke up while he was still hanging upside down, so he couldn't help but sway his body powerfully. Originally, the loop of wire was only supposed to slip off the doorknob. But because there was a heavier load than expected, the doorknob ended up breaking.
No, not heavier load than expected, because he nearly ripped the doorknob out the day before.
Nekomaru fell from the fourth floor all the way to the first floor. He crashed into the pillar, which decapitated him on impact, and died. The sound of Nekomaru's impact echoed throughout the funhouse. However, by this point, the killer's plan was about to fail, thanks to the broken doorknob and Fuyuhiko.
Notice how the wires are all missing in that picture?
Meaning, the killer is someone who wouldn't have heard the alarm if they were in the deluxe room. They also wouldn't have been able to return to their guest room, because Fuyuhiko was at the lounge.
Oh, is he gonna have hamsters?
That someone is Gundam Tanaka. I can't think of anyone else but you.
That's a nice picture of him.
Splendid.
I'm gonna see if he actually changes his voice or anything.
That was splendid! For a mere human, you did quite well.
Oh god, is he actually gonna be Chunin right through to the end?
Stop. Stop it already. Stop using weird words to avoid the truth. Or I'll friggin' kill you myself!
I cannot believe it. I just cannot believe. You killed Nekomaru? I cannot believe something like that!
You don't wish to forgive me. Do you feel regret?
I still like him. Murderer or not. Hell, I like him even more. He killed Nekomaru. That's fucking bonus points in my book.
Then finish it! Cast your impure votes for Gundam Tanaka!
Like I said, I want to give him a high five, pat him on the back, and send him on his way.
My beloved, deadly foes, let the voting time begin!
Holy crap, there's a lot of stuff. Oh god, we never actually got to spend any of our coins the last time around. We're gonna have a lot of...
This result isn't all that exciting.
A lot of vending machine to do.
Now then, please pull the lever in front of you and cast your vote! Who will be chosen as the blackened? Will you make the right choice or the dreadfully wrong one? Please pull the lever! Crap! I bit my tongue at the most important part!
Wasn't aware the bear had a tongue. I'm gonna guess Sonya didn't vote for him regardless.
I bit my tongue again, so I'll speak slowly. Judging from the results,
Yahoo!
You guys were correct once again. Getting four in a row without any mistakes is a splendid achievement. That's right, the one who killed the robotic Nekomaru in the amazing funhouse
Yaha!
Was Megatron Jones.
Nice!
Or Gundam Tanaka. I said all that without biting my tongue.
Now then.
Now we've decided who the killer is. Let's do the execution already and get this over with. If there were only three people in the class trial, the killer kills the remaining two classmates. Does the killer get away? Well, I guess they go, they have trial, they talk to themselves for a bit, and then they vote for somebody else. It's true the class trial is finished, but that doesn't mean the incident is over. We can't finish yet until we hear it from Gundam.
Jeez.
No matter what he says, it won't change a thing. Well, I have no right to stop you either, so do whatever you like.
Fall, my tears.
Why do you want to talk to one who has lost? The loser merely leaves. It would just be unnecessary for me to say something.
Listen well!
Is what I would like to say, but for honor's sake, I shall correct one thing. Correct?
How pitiful.
You guys said I made Nekomaru powerless without fighting him. That, however, is a great mistake. Huh?
Fine.
Nekomaru did fight. That is no mistake. And because he fought, he lost and died.
Damn it!
Lost and died?
This, too, must be the will of causality.
If he was just trying to cling to life, there are many ways he could have done so. However, he did not allow that.
You!
What do you mean? Explain. Fine, then. I shall reveal it all.
Let's make history.
Within the final dead room, I discovered the secret of the funhouse. And I devised a killing plan utilizing that secret. By tampering with all the clocks in the building, I succeeded in luring Nekomaru to the tower. And this is what happened. Nice. That is a nice picture of him. Nekomaru and I were alone in the tower, standing face to face with one another. I should say I expected as much from Nekomaru. He sensed my subtle killing intent and instantly understood the situation. And we had ourselves a stare down. In that situation, if he wanted to run away, it would have been easy for him to do so. He could have run away, or even called for help. But he did not turn his back to me. Instead, he chose a fight that risked life and death.
That is...
A fight that risked life and death?
Let me tell you
he
this.
He was serious, too. He gave it his all to try to kill me.
Huh?
If I had died instead, the mystery surrounding the case would have been even more complicated. You would never have known why I, the victim, went to the tower by myself.
I can see it!
Nobody would know that the victim, me, was actually the one who planned the whole thing. Kind of like that first trial in that other game.
Could it be?
Nekomaru really did that?
Sensing even my subtle killing intent, as expected of you, Nekomaru.
The scorching, stinging, tense atmosphere! I've been a team manager for so long, I'd nearly forgotten this! This is great! What a comforting atmosphere!
That's a great line.
And what is your reason? Do you intend to resolve this situation by killing me?
I am the Warlock, Gundam Tanaka! Heroes, Lords of Darkness, and even the gods themselves flee from me!
hiding need not cling to any trivial reason. I'm simply going to kill you because your very existence is an annoyance.
See, Gundam and I definitely think alike.
You'll drench your soul with evil until the bitter end, huh? Splendid! In response to your spirit, I shall kill you with all of my might. I won't go easy on you. Don't even think about holding back. Don't waste your breath on cowardly tactics. Give me everything you got!
Nekomaru Nidai, your blood will drench the foundation of my empire!
That is such an awesome picture of him.
That is...
Why? Why did you fight? We were all friends. Why couldn't you stop this? Even if both sides agreed, it was still wrong. I will not argue. I have no intention of forcing my values upon you.
Let me tell you
this. Oh god, Steve, what is that? That's pretty much what I picture. I'm saving that as well. Like I said, we're gonna have a dance off and scream at each other. So that's pretty much it, yeah. That's roughly what I expected. Cheers, Steve. Oh, you know what? Throw some butter knives out for that. That's just magnificent. What's the point of living if you're just waiting until you finally die?
You weakling!
There's nothing courageous about that. Have I ever considered adding a link for all of Steve's arcs? You'd have to ask Steve where he stores it all in the end. I just save all of it locally. This is abandonment, a mere feeling of resignation. Wait, are you telling us to just wait until we starve to death? I'd rather have that happen to us than have our friends kill each other. Huh? Do you mean that you'd rather die?
Fall, my tears.
Ever since we were locked inside that building, everyone has been dominated by that feeling of abandonment. However, nothing is born from resignation. That is simply a reason to give up.
If you flinch, you will die!
Giving up on life, that's just an insult to life itself.
Let me ask.
You fools heard of the term dog-eat-dog? Cannibalism?
Fine.
In zoology, cannibalism is a commonly observed phenomenon. Many creatures at some point in their lifespan engage in cannibalism.
Listen well!
That is what it means to live. You say killing for the sake of living is evil, then what would you call giving up on life itself?
I shall engulf this world.
If a world would consider that justice, then I will fight that world with every last fiber of my being. Giving up on life and choosing death is nothing but a blasphemy toward life.
I renounce you!
It is a violation of the natural order. It is the arrogance of humanity.
You...
Are you saying all that to try to justify what you did?
But...
It sounds like Nekomaru felt the same too. That's why they fought, right?
Damn it!
Fine.
That man had the courage to die when he needed to die. That is why he challenged me to our battle. Regardless, as I've already said, I do not intend to force my values upon you fools. I have betrayed you all. That is the absolute truth.
Fall, my tears.
But, even so... Don't you think it's a better alternative to slowly starving to death here?
Oh.
That belief is why you committed your crime.
You...
Hey, what about the final dead room? Did you do the Russian roulette too?
Let's make history.
Unlike Nagato, I only did it once, but... compared to my battle with Nekomaru, that was mere child's play.
Well?
You know, after listening to you talk for a while, I'm starting to think that... Well, it's also because you unexpectedly admitted your crime without much resistance. Gundam, don't tell me. You didn't sacrifice yourself for our sake, did you? I can't believe you would ask such a foolish question.
My name is Gundam Tanaka!
History's greatest monster. My cursed existence is feared by all mankind. There's no way I'd sacrifice myself for the sake of you fools.
Fade like dust in the wind!
Not in a million, not in a billion, not in 10,000 billion years? In the name of Pandemonium, it is impossible. Is that it? Then, I'll just leave it at that. Now then, let us be rid of this foolish talk. It's about time the fun started. Monokuma, let us begin.
Yes, indeed.
I prepared a special punishment for the ultimate breeder, Gundam Tanaka.
Please wait!
This is just too much.
I beg of you!
Please, Monokuma, please help Gundam.
Huh?
Miss Sonya?
I beg of you!
How pitiful.
Sonya, an act as unrefined as stopping a man from going to his death does not befit a noble such as yourself. Gundam.
Let's find a star for reals, right?
Fine.
Yes, I do not mind. However...
What is it, my four dark devas of destruction? Are you worried about me? Oh, my feared four dark devas of destruction. That is not like you at all.
So, what do you figure? Sonya gonna, inherit the hamsters?
However, there is no need to
Sonya
fear.
Gundam ship
sinks. In this world, I am only a temporary visitor. I was simply visiting for a moment, and now that my duty is complete, I must return to the darkness. That is why, until the very end, pride, conceit, courage, insolence, fearful of nothing, daunted by nothing, let us laugh uproariously! That is Gundam Tanaka! I shall stick with my evil until the very end! Open Sesame Pandemonium! I shall fill hell with true hell!
Let's give it everything we've got! It's punishment time!
Tell me the hamsters are going away. Good man. For our buddy. He killed the character I most wanted to die off, and he died like a fucking badass. Cheers, Gundam Tanaka. Good man. You know, did not break character until the end. You gotta respect that. Hell, you know what? Raise your butter knives for Gundam Tanaka. I love that guy. I am going to miss him. But that did make for a pretty awesome showdown between him and Nekomaru. And thank you, Gundam, for offing Nekomaru for me. I really, really appreciate it. Even after Gundam is gone, the spirit of his parting words still linger deep in our chests. Don't give up on life. Did I misunderstand what he meant? Then what's the right thing to do? I don't know. I don't know how much I think about it. I don't know if I'll ever be able to answer that.
Damn it.
Gundam released you from the boredom of Chapter 4. The trial was a lot more interesting than the rest of the chapter, thankfully. I'm so pissed off, I need to throw something. Hey, there's Monokuma right over there.
Damn it!
You all spent so much time worrying about each other. Thanks to that, things ended up like this. You're all full of shit, every last one of you. The biggest piece of shit is me.
The worst.
Damn it, why am I so weak?
Oh.
It's such a downer, clearly. But still, even though we feel this way, we still gotta do our very best.
You are right.
This time around, we must move forward. We must continue to live and believe in our friends. If not...
You are right.
Gundam will most likely crawl his way out of hell, and I presume he'll be very cross with us. You're right. We shouldn't just stand here. I mean, it's not like this is over. We still have things, or we still have to do it. We still have to finish this. For the sake of our friends who have died, we need to finish this once and for all. This chapter was a balancing act for me, killing off one of my least favorite and one of my favorites. Stand up and walk. Move forward. Live. If you don't, everyone who fought and died will have died in vain. Can't allow that.
Hey! Hey!
So how long are you guys gonna stand around chattering? Class trial is over, so it's okay for you to hurry back over to Jabberwock Island. However, the killing school trip will proceed as usual, so make sure you know that.
Wait!
How much longer are you gonna keep doing this? Well, we're down to 7. Seriously, how long is he gonna keep doing this? How long is this going to continue?
Now then.
Alright, after feeling down for so long, I finally feel refreshed. Let's hurry back and eat some food.
Hey!
Hold on a sec. That mood shift is too damn fast.
It's not like that.
I will admit I have a certain selfish reason for also being happy that Gundam's dead. Man, doing his voice was killing my throat. Now I don't have to anymore. That's what it means to live, right?
Huh.
She's certainly something else. Seriously, I'm starving.
Hey.
Let's go back for now and eat. And then after we're full, let's sleep as much as we want.
Right?
And then let's do our best again. Yeah, you're right. With this, the class trial has come to an end, and once again, we return to Jabberwock Island. The size of our group is definitely diminished. And despite that, even if it was just the rest of us, we did our best to stay upbeat and have fun together. Of course, our optimism was only superficial. At that moment, we were able to forget about the dark despair looming before us. However, the only thing I was worried about was him. He wasn't there. He suddenly disappeared from our sight. Oh, Nagito, what the fuck are you doing? Yep, I'm definitely lucky. I never expected to obtain so many valuable things from a simple game of Russian roulette. Thanks to that, I was able to learn the identity of our true enemy. And before everyone else, too. That's just too funny. I mean, no one could tell that I was lying. There's no way the file had just Hajime's information. That's what I thought.
Well...
I guess they were too busy with other matters. Or maybe they've reached their limit. Regardless, I was saved. Things would get complicated if they found out. Anyway, I can't forgive this.
Damn it!
This should never be forgiven. There's no way I can let this run loose. I'll be the one who stops this once and for all. Even if it costs me my life.
It's obvious!
For the sake of hope, I cannot ignore this. Everyone's least favorite character?
Monokuma appears!
My least favorite character. That's probably a triple up between... Oh, Nekomaru. Teruteru. And Mikan. Though to tell you the truth, I disliked Mikan less by the end because that was a pretty magnificent show she put on. So I guess it's a toss-up between Nekomaru and Teruteru.
Now then.
Thanks for coming.
What's this?
That's the lonely little Nagato. Are you all alone tonight, too?
What's the matter?
So what's up? Your face looks scary. I see, so you can tell.
I like Mikan? Whiny bitches don't do well with me. I don't like people who are incompetent and cry a lot. It's pathetic and sad and just irritates me a lot. But the fact was, in the end, she nutted up, fucking killed two people, and did a pretty good job of it, so my opinion never rose a lot at that point. The pointlessly crass fan service did not help either. You know me well.
Well.
That's what I'd like to say, but unfortunately I haven't learned that yet. Let's see. So even though you don't know, huh? Looks like the final showdown is gonna take a little more time.
Hello.
So why'd you summon me anyway? Are you finally gonna confess your love?
Hey.
I summoned you because there's something I really need to ask you. It's about the special prize from the final dead room. Oh yeah? What about it? There was information about 16 people in the file I received. Isn't that weird?
Say what?
What's weird?
The fact that there's 16 when there was only supposed to be 15, but apparently there really wasn't.
You don't even know?
Well, there's a traitor from the Future Foundation hiding among us, right? Including that person, the total number of students would be 16, right?
Isn't that right?
But this file contains documents that were created at Hope's Peak Academy, right?
Of course!
That's right. I just reused the stuff that the former headmaster spent a lot of time making.
What?
This file even contains information about the traitor. Was that person also a former student of Hope's Peak Academy?
Who knows?
I wonder.
Hey.
Could it be? Is this your doing? That you slip false information into the file? Are you trying to keep us from learning the traitor's identity by obtaining this information? What's wrong with that?
Mihira was pretty normal. I had no issues with her. I had no particular love for her, nor did I have any particular issue with her. Kind of wish I'd hit her up for a spare time at least once to get a better feel for her, but I'm really sad, though, that in her death, she didn't manage to catch a photograph of anything that would have helped us. I would have expected that from the ultimate photographer. Well, Mihira was less developed than TerraTerra because, let's face it, most of TerraTerra's information came out during the trial. Mihira was kind of dead for the trial, so
it's my job to heat things up. It's okay if I do something small like that, right?
Well,
that's not my point.
Right?
My point is, you already know who the traitor is. What's wrong with that?
You're getting all riled up!
Oh, you're splendidly correct when you say, I knew who the traitor was all along. Even though I know who it is, why do you think I ignored it on purpose? It's just like Monami after losing her magic stick. The traitor's existence means absolutely nothing to me. Their existence means nothing, huh?
No, no!
And that's just how I feel. I'm sure you guys feel somewhat different.
Shing!
After all, that person is the evil Future Foundation lackey who's putting you guys through this awful stuff. That's not entirely true. I didn't really come here to fight or anything like that. Instead, I came here to offer my cooperation, you know?
Huh?
Cooperation?
Hey!
Your purpose is to fill everyone on this island with despair, right? That's why you're intentionally letting the traitor do as they please, right?
Yep.
If that's the case, I might be able to cooperate somewhat, too.
Right?
However, in exchange, I want to know who the traitor is. I see. Interesting. Very interesting.
No, no, no!
Obviously, that's a big no-no.
Unbelievable.
I want to make everyone in your group feel despair. That includes you, too.
Well,
I knew you would say that. Besides, I just wouldn't be able to handle the sadness when you inevitably betray me later on. Just as I thought, you saw right through me.
You're right.
No matter what situation I find myself in, my core way of thinking will never change. In order to create absolute hope that shines brightly, stepladders such as myself and despair exist. You're right. You're a true believer of hope, after all.
Oh, Nagito's been willingly... Well, he's been willing to put himself in the cutting block for the entire game. In fact, he was quite frustrated on a few occasions when someone died without, essentially, killing him.
I must say, that belief reminds me of that person for some reason.
Huh?
Reminds you? I don't know who you're talking about, but if someone as worthless as me reminds you of some other person, like maybe Makoto Naegi.
Man,
they must be extremely unlucky.
Like?
You know, just as unlucky, right? I mean, the fact they're even involved in something like this.
Wow.
Am I? I actually think I'm very lucky.
Say what?
You don't know?
Wouldn't you say that coming across this much despair is a rather rare opportunity? I can't rely on anyone on this island. That's why I have to be the one who does it. If I can eliminate despair from this island, I won't be a stepladder anymore. I'll become true hope. I'll become an existence that could even be called ultimate hope. The two of you are alike. You definitely remind me of him.
Hey.
There's one more thing I want to ask you.
Hmm? See?
Who are you waiting for on this island? Looks like I'm right again. You're definitely waiting for someone on this island. Is the person you're waiting for already on this island?
Hey.
Well, answer my question. If that's the case, if that person is already on this island, like say maybe inside that bunker that's been sealed and maybe won't open until that timer hits down, wouldn't that be exciting?
New challenger in... Five days, 11 hours, 13 minutes, 30 seconds. There's stuff I like about Akane, but the fact is, she's hero levels of dumb, and I can't tell if that means she needs to die, or if she's actually gonna survive to the end, because Hiro did too, in spite of being a complete and absolute moron. It's almost a little bit sad. Oh, we got his earring.